You know, I think there's a point in every person's life that's a hyper fan of anything where they realize, I am going to think about this series every day for the rest of my life. And you know what? I'm just fine with that. For me, that series is Saint Seiya, and I want you to join in on my little obsession, frustration, and joy. Years ago, I would have described Saint Seiya by saying, it's what happens when you take Dragon Ball, Power Rangers, and Greek mythology, and put it in the blender. Which is still not a bad description, but I must go deeper. Saint Seiya is a series you just don't see anymore, an old school shonen brawler. If you are aware of the series, you know why it's not very popular in the West, but if not, to summarize, it had to do with bad dubbing and censorship. But that was not the case for Latin America, which is a bulk of the fandom. I have never heard much of that atrocious dubbing, if at all, but I do know they replaced the theme song with a cover of Flock of Seagulls' I Ran So Far Away. I'll leave it at that. So it's stuck in this zone of being unknown yet clearly influential to modern shonen. But as of late 2019, Toei had decided to put a little bit of effort into exposing the franchise to the West. So it's only natural that I, a longtime fan, make a little bit of effort as well. Okay, here we go. It's 70% action with story and characters that are interesting and deep enough for you to get into and better than it will ever get credit for, and will even surprise you just how often it will hit you in the feels. The action. While I did compare it to Dragon Ball in my opinion is more martial arts inspired super combat, while Saint Seiya is more about brutal super attacks with characters that can shoot millions of lightning bolts in a second, characters with ice-based attacks that hit at absolute zero temperature, dramatic sensor-moving abilities, light-based attacks that send you to hell or even out of existence entirely, pure blasts of energy that hit with the force of a galactic explosion, even techniques as diverse as reducing a character's power down to 10% by playing a flute. All revolves around igniting the inner cosmic power known as Cosmo. Saint Seiya action at its peak, it's kinda like insanely powerful warrior wizards doing combat, and it is very violent and bloody and on occasion gory. So be warned, if you aren't a fan of blood, this series is not for you. Oh, that leads me to another reason that may not be a big one for many, but it was a bit of a factor for me. It's a OP as heck series. The strongest characters are just like god warriors. They can move faster than light, manipulate dimensions, even split atoms on an atomic level. And then you have the gods themselves, powerful and intimidating. They can flood the entire world, rearrange solar systems, even open portals from another world just to kill someone close to the hero. All this against our main characters who fight using very basic techniques, but keep going due to willpower and heart. Again, classic shonen underdog stuff, but shot up to 11. And of course, the characters. I like all of the main characters. And yes, they can come across as a bit trite. You can put them into boxes and go, well, this character is the Vegeta, this character is the Hiei. But I find them all likable characters with their own interesting background and hopes that keep them fighting. Especially Shun, whose passive nature contrasts with the other heroes who have sent their fair share of poor bastards to the underworld. But what the series greatly excels at are the side characters. Or rather, all the antagonists that block the hero's path, particularly characters like the Gold Saints. They are powerful, and I don't mean that in strength. I mean in sheer presence, personality, strong presentation, and the way they develop over the course of the series, both subtle and unsubtle. They are very endearing characters. You are given just enough to either hate or love them, but they are still mysterious enough that it will leave you wanting more. Same can be said for even the most minor of characters. Fans simply eat up any material showcasing them, even if their want is based mostly off of presentation, potential, and design. Definitely fan fiction fodder for all. Yes, another thing to love about this series is theme and design. The series above all others is what created my love for cool armor in fiction. The designs of the Saints' armor and sometimes weapons are based off their constellation, meaning there are 88 cloths, each with their own unique design that fit within three ranks: bronze, silver, and gold, all of which are based off their constellation's animal or myth. And similarly, you have the 108 stars of destiny for the warriors of the underworld. And of course, you have the Greek mythology theme. While each spin-off uses Greek mythology or other mythos in various degrees, the classic uses it more for background and lore. It is all, luckily, to the benefit of the story and world building. Talking purely of the classic anime, while I'm sure it is often said by many fans of any anime or game franchise they like, I and many in the fandom truly believe that the soundtrack to Saint Seiya is some of the best in all of anime. Composer Seiji Yokoyama, also known for his work on Captain Harlock, did the music for this anime, and he simply gives you everything you can ask for in an OST. Multiple strong, epic music, very somber, sad music, music that will get you hyped.
Master, please forgive me.
Rising Dragon!
Even the classic moody ending music. It simply never fails in fitting the mood. And I suggest everyone go on YouTube and type Saint Seiya OST and listen. I promise you will not be disappointed. And the best reason you should get into this series is that it has something for everyone. Saint Seiya is luckily one of those series that has multiple spin-offs that act as expanded universe or a retelling of events. Each of these mangas have the heart of the classic, but made by fans that bring their own unique style and look to the franchise, each with their own strengths and weaknesses. Even Knights of the Zodiac, I think, is something that would be great for kids. Why you should give each of these stories a shot is a video for another time, but I will say, if you think the concept for Saint Seiya is good, but you also feel the classic is a bit dated, these stories provide a more modern and deeper take on the classic. And those are the reasons to watch Saint Seiya, as simple and to the point as the series itself. So I hope you give it a shot, because now is the best time. You have Toei making an effort to appeal to the West by creating a CGI remake and casting an entirely new dub and sub for the classic anime. They even dubbed The Lost Canvas. 2019 was an interesting year for the series because of all that, and 2020 may even be better, with season 4 and 5 of the classic coming along with Knights of the Zodiac, with the classic covering the best arc of Saint Seiya. Even a live action film reportedly being done by the director of The Witcher. Now, the series has its flaws. It has hiatus issues, can be very repetitive at times, and the protagonists not being the best characters within their stories is a thing in whichever spin-off you choose to read. Still, the series is special, and no matter the time or era, it has everything to be as popular as many animes today or the past in the West. So I hope I convinced at least some of you to give the franchise a shot, and we can all come together and see exactly what the future holds for this great series. I am positive the series will reach the greatest height it was always meant to achieve, having its armor designs harshly criticized by Shadowversity. And that's it, everyone. I hope you enjoyed this video. This was definitely different than what I'm usually doing. Definitely harder, so I hope you enjoyed this in the end. And please remember to like and subscribe and hit the bell, or not. I'm kind of an asshole, to be honest. So just check out the gosh darn series. Later. Wait, now what are some other cool things about this series? There's a guy that trains by choking bears, huh? What else? It's credited for having a huge influence on the yaoi genre and popularized the name yaoi itself. Just check it out, guys. I don't know.